एवं वर्तमान अज्ञ मृत्युकाले उपस्थिते मतिन चकार तनय बाली नारायणा हवै। वर्तमान एवरी वन इज सिचुएटेड अंडर सर्टेन कंडीशन, दिस इज मेटीरियल लाइफ। आई एम सिचुएटेड अंडर सर्टेन कॉन्शसनेस, यू आर सिचुएटेड इन सर्टेन कॉन्शसनेस, एवरी वन according to the modes of nature, we have got different conception of life and different consciousness. That is called material life. All of us, we are sitting here, every one of us has got a different consciousness. Generally, it is meant for sense gratification. Material life means everyone is planning, I shall live like this, I shall acquire money like this, I shall enjoy like this. Everyone has got a program. So Ajamil also had a program. What was his program? His program was that he is very much attached to his youngest child, and whole attention is there, how the child is moving, how the child is eating, how the child is talking, and sometimes he was calling, he was feeding. So his whole mind was absorbed with the activities of the child. In the previous verse we have already discussed, Bunyanam Prabhuvan Khadan बालकं स्नेहजन भोजयन पायन मूढ़ न भेद आगतम अंतकम। नॉट ओनली अजामिल, एवरी वन, दे आर एब्जॉर्ब इन सर्टेन टाइप ऑफ कॉन्शसनेस एंड व्हाट इज ड्यू टू इट, हाउ द कॉन्शसनेस डेवलप, इट इज ए स्नेहजन। Sneha means affection. By the affected by the machine, which is called affection. So everyone is affected by this machine. This machine, this body is machine, and it is being worked by the nature, and direction is coming from the Supreme Lord. We wanted to enjoy a certain way, and Krishna has given us a certain type of body, jantra. Just like you have got different makes of motor car. Somebody wants, I want big car, somebody says, I want similar race, Ford. They are ready. Similarly, our body is also like that. Somebody is Ford, somebody is Chevrolet, somebody is big. And Krishna has given us the chance. He wanted this kind of car or body, you sit down and enjoy. This is our material position. Ishvara sarva-bhutanam riddeshe arjuna tishtati. We forget, after changing the body, we forget what I desire and why I've got this kind of body. But Krishna, He is situated within your heart, He does not forget. He gives you. Jejathavāng prapadyante. He wanted this kind of body, You get it? Krishna is so kind. If somebody wanted a body so that he can eat everything, so Krishna gives him the body of a pig, so it can eat even stool. And if somebody wanted a body that I shall dance with Krishna, then he gets that body. Now it is up to you to decide whether you are going to get a body which will be able to dance with Krishna, to talk with Krishna, to play with Krishna. You can get it. And if you want a body, how to eat stool, urine, you'll get it. So we have to decide this human form of life. But if you have no information that what kind of body I'm going to get next, if you don't believe, you believe or not believe, it doesn't matter. The nature's law will act. If you say, I don't believe in the next life, you may say like that, but nature's law will act. Karmana daiva natre, na? As you are acting, according to that you are preparing your next body. So after death means when this body is finished, then you get another body immediately, because you have already made the filled one. What kind of body you will get? So, this man, Ajamin, was engaged in taking care of his child very nicely, and the whole mind was absorbed in the child. So, don't disturb. Therefore, he has been described as Murha. He has been said, Bhojan Parayana Murha. We are forgetting that someday is coming, that is ahead, that is called Mrityu, death. We forget that. But this is our imperfect. So this man forgot that he was very busy as affectionate father or affectionate husband. Already though I got so many relationships as an affectionate friend or envious enemy. We have got some relations with everyone, with this world. We have got some. Either it may be affectionate or envy. It doesn't matter. So, in this way we are living, forgetting that death is ahead. Therefore, we are Murha. Murha means rascal, ass, who does not know what is actual interest. This ass, ass, this. Murha means ass. The ass does not know his own interest. We have seen that ass is loaded with 3 tons of cloth by the washerman, and he cannot go still, he has to do it. And he does not know that I am loading so many tons of cloth on my back, and what interest I've got with it. Not a single cloth belongs to me. So the ass has no success. Ass means he has no success. He is thinking it is my duty to load upon me so much clothing. It is my duty. Why it is duty? Because the washerman gives you grass. So he has no sense that grass I can get anywhere. Why I have taken this duty? So this is the everyone is anxious about his duty, somebody is politician, somebody is householder, somebody is something else. But because he has taken up some false duty and working hard for it, therefore he is an ass. He is forgetting his real business. Real business is that death will come. It will not have hurt me. Everyone says, as sure as death. Now before death, I have to act in such a way that I may have a position in Vaikuntha, in Vrindavan, and I may have permanent life to live with Krishna. This is our real duty. But we do not know that. Nate vidu sarthakatin hi Vishnu. We are in this conditioned state of life because we are separated from our original person, Krishna, because we are part and parcel of Krishna. We have forgotten this. We are thinking we are part and parcel of America or India. This is called illusion. They are interested, somebody is interested in his country, somebody is interested in his society or family. We have created so many things, duty. Therefore, Shastra says that these rascals do not know what is his actual self-interest. Nate vidu sarthagatim hi Vishnu durasaya. He is hoping something which will never be fulfilled. That's what is rascal. We are trying to adjust things within this material world to become happy, but the rascal does not know that so long he will remain in this material world, there is no question of happiness. That is rascal. Krishna says that this place is dukkhalam asasatam. This material world where we are now living under different change of body, one after another, it is dukkhalam. Why I have to change my body? Why not? I am permanent. Na arnati hannamane sarire. Therefore we have to learn. We have to be educated. We have to receive knowledge from the perfect. And Krishna personally, the supreme perfect person, is giving you knowledge. And if you are so unfortunate that you do not take the perfect knowledge, we concoct, we speculate, we create our own idea, then it is to be understood that durasaya. We are thinking, I shall be happy in this way, I shall be happy in this way. Nothing. You shall never be happy. This is perfect nistar. Unless you go back to home, back to God. Just like a mad boy, he has forsaken his father. His father is rich man, everything is there, but he has become hippie. So, similarly, we are also like that. Our father is Krishna. We can live there very comfortably, without any botheration, without endeavor for earning money. But we have decided that we shall live here in this material. This is called ass. This is the, therefore, murha. We do not know what is our self-interest. And we are hoping against hope. I shall be happy in this way, I shall be happy in this way. Therefore, this word is used, murha. They do not know what is actually his happiness and is trying one chapter another, now I will be happy. The ass, sometimes the washerman sits on his back and takes a bunch of grass and puts in front of the ass, and the ass wants to take the grass, but as he's moving forward, the grass is also moving forward. and he thinks just one step forward I shall get the grass. But because he is ass, he does not know that the grass is situated in such a way that I may go on for millions of years, still I will not get the earth. This is ass. He does not come to his senses that for millions and trillions of years I may try to be happy in this material world, I will never be happy. Therefore, you have to take the knowledge from the Guru who knows things. Therefore, Guru is worshipped. Ajñāna-timirāndhasya jñānānjana-salākaya cakṣu-ulminitam-jena tasmai sri-gurave. The politician or what is called leaders, andhra, they will promise you that you will be happy in this way, you give me vote and I shall bring heaven for you and let me become minister, that is all, you simply wait. And as soon as I become a minister and president, I will give you such and such benefit. So you select Mr. Nixon. And again you become disappointed. Then we request Mr. Nixon, you get out. And we accept another fool. This is good. This is good. But Shastra said you will not be getting right information in that way. This foolish man, they will promise you something and he is unable to make you happy, he will be again disappointed, again regret. Then where from I shall get the right information? That Veda says, tad vijñānārtham sa gurumeva avigacche. If you want right information, then go to the Guru. And who is Guru? That Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explains, that amara gai guru haiya taro sarva. He says, you just become on my order. Guru means who carries the order of Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna. Or who is Krishna's servant, that is Guru. Nobody can become Guru unless he carries the order of the Supreme. Therefore, you will find, because every one of us, yes, we do not know what is our self-interest, and somebody comes, I am Guru. How you become Guru? No, I am self-perfected. I don't require to read any book. I have come to bless you. And the foolish rascals, they do not know how he can become Guru. If he does not follow the Shastra or the Supreme Authority, Krishna, how he can become? But they accept Guru. So this kind of Guru is going on. But you should know, Guru means who carries the order of the Supreme Lord. That is Guru. Any rascal who manufactures some idea is not Guru. Immediately kick him out. Immediately. That is, this is a rascal, this is not a Guru. Guru is here, as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said. Amar ajñāy guru haiya. Guru means the faithful servant of God. That is Guru. So you have to first of all test, are you faithful servant of God? If he says, no, I am God, kick him on his face immediately. Kick him immediately. That you are us. You have come to cheat us. Because test is there, that Guru means faithful servant of God. Simple. You don't require large definition what is Guru. So Vedic knowledge gives you indication that tad-vijñānārtham. If you want to know the science of spiritual life, tad-vijñānārtham. So guru-meva-vigacchet, you must approach Guru. And who is Guru? Guru means who is the faithful servant of God. Very simple. So, this is the position. Without Guru, if he is manufacturing his way of life, then he is Murha, rascal. Therefore it is said, Murha. You are thinking, I am so affectionate father, I am taking care of my son, little son. In all respect, I am feeding him, I am petting him, so many things I am very faithful and very honest father. But Shastra says, here is a Murha, rascal. You see here, he says, bhojayan panayan Murha. Why is Murha? Na vedam agatam antakam. He does not see, does not know that behind me the death is awaiting. He has come to take me. Now, how your affection for your so-called son and society and family and nation will save you? Here is death. That he cannot have. He can, cannot answer. The death is there. So we shall be prepared. That is human life. We must always know that there is death behind me. At any moment he can capture my neck and take it. That's a fact. Is there any guarantee that you shall live 100 years? No. Even just after a few seconds, if you go to this state, you may immediately meet death. There may be heart failure, there may be motor accident, there may be something. So, to live is wonderful. To die is not wonderful. Because you are meant for death. As soon as you took your birth, immediately you begin to die. Immediately. If you inquire, when the child is born, you say 1 week. That means he has died 1 week. We are taking that he is living 1 week, but actually he has died 1 week. That is wonderful. That is still he is living, he has not died. So death is not wonderful, because it is sure, it will come after 1 week or after 100 years. That is not wonderful. So long you live, that is wonderful. So we should utilize this time to make solution of the life that we are repeatedly dying and again accepting another body. So how they will understand unless they come to the proper Guru? Therefore Shastra says, tad-vijñānārtham. If you want to know the real problem of your life, and if you want to be enlightened, how to become Krishna conscious, how to become eternal, go back to home, back to Godhead, then you must approach the Guru. And who is Guru? That is explained, very simple thing. Guru never manufactures idea that you do this and give me money and you become happy. That is not good. There is another process of earning money. So, here it is said, Murha, everyone who is simply living in the fool's paradise, manufacturing his own ideas, like Ajami, somebody has taken, this is my duty, somebody has taken. He is a fool. You must know what is your duty from Guru. You are singing every day, Guru Mukha Padma Vakya Chittete Koriya Vakya Arana Koriya Vanya. This is life. This is life. Guru Mukha Padma, you accept the bona fide Guru and what he orders you, carry out. Then your life is successful. Arana Koriya Vanya. You rascal, you do not desire anything else. Are you not singing daily? But do you understand the meaning? Or we are singing only? What is the meaning? We'll explain. Nobody knows? Yes? What is the meaning?
My only wish is that my mind be purified by the words and the mouth of my spiritual master. I have no other desire than
anything else. Yes, this is the order. Guru Mukha Padma Bhakka Chitta Te Koriyai. Now, chitta means consciousness or heart. I shall do this only. But my Guru Maharaj told me, I shall do this. Chitta Te Koriyai Akka Arna Koriyo Maniyas. So, it is not my pride, but I can say for your instruction, I did it. Therefore, whatever little success you see, than all my God brothers, it is due to this. I have no capacity. But I took it, the words of my Guru, as life and soul. So this is fact. Guru Mukha Padma Bhakka Chitta Te Koriyaka. Everyone should do that. But if he makes addition, alteration, then he is finished. No addition, alteration. You have to approach Guru. Guru means the faithful servant of God, Krishna, and take his word how to serve him. Then you are successful. If you concord, I am very intelligent than my Guru, and I can make additional alteration, then you are finished. So that is the only. Sing further.
Siguru
charane rati sei si uttama gati. If you want to make real progress, then you must be firmly faithful at the lotus feet of Guru. Then je prasade pure sarva as. Jasya prasada, this is the instruction in the whole Vaishnava philosophy. So unless we do that, we remain murha, and this is explained in the Gajami Lupakhan. So today we are reading this verse. Saivam Bhattamana Agya. Again he says. Again, Vyasadeva says that this rascal was situated in that absorbed in the service of his son, Narayana, of the name. He did not know what is this nonsense Narayana. He knew his son. But Narayana is so merciful that because he was constantly calling his son, Narayana, please come here. Narayana, please take this. So Krishna was taking that he's chanting Narayana. Krishna is so merciful. He never meant that I am going to Narayana. He wanted his son because he was affectionate. But he got the opportunity of chanting the holy name of Narayana. This is his good fortune. Therefore, according to this, we change the name. Why? Because every name is meant for becoming a servant of Krishna. So just like Upendra. Upendra means Bhavande. So if we call Upendra, Upendra or similarly, that name is taken account of. So that will be explained later on. So here also it is same. In the first verse it is said Mura, and the second verse also it is said Saivam Bhattamana Agya. Agya means rascal. Mura means rascal, Agya means ignorant. Ignorant, who has no knowledge. Ga means one who has knowledge. Agya, man who has no knowledge. Mrityukala upasthiti. So everyone in this material world is murha, agya, he does not care that I will have to meet death when everything will be finished, all my plans, all my assets, everything will be finished. He does not know that. He knows it, but he doesn't care to observe in these things. Therefore, everyone is mura and agya. In spite of the death has come, matin chakara tonai bali narayano avah. He is experiencing, now I am dying, death is near, still he is thinking of his, that child. So, jang-jang bapi smaran loke, tajat-tanta, he has got a child, his name is Narayana. Now his position is different, but if I am similarly affected, similarly affectionate to my dog, then what is my position? Or anything. Naturally I will think of my dog and immediately I shall get the another body like a dog or dog. This is nature's law. Jang-jang bapi smaran loki tajat-tanti kalevaram. At the time, the test will be at the time of death. What kind of body you are going to get. So jang-jang bapi smaran bhavam. They, just like he is very much affectionate to his son, he is thinking of his son. Similarly, if you are very much affectionate to your dog or something else, you will think at that time. Therefore, practice Hare Krishna, so that at the time of death you can think of Krishna and your life is successful. Thank you very much.
Krishna Vestaya Udane Lakshmi Vestaya.